flips it to Hadashell, going right with blockers. Hadashell cuts it upfield. Hadashell down the far sideline. He's got the sideline. He's at the 35, the 30, the 20, the 15, the 10. Touchdown, Sabres. It's just windy. It's an overcast sky, but I think all in all, this is nice weather for high school football.
Yeah, if you can stay out of the wind, it's beautiful. That wind will cut through you before too long.
Yeah, that's right. Fortunately, it's out of the west, southwest, and it is coming. You know, obviously, the field runs north and south. Mm-hmm. So kind of going to the north, and we'll be with the wind a little bit.
A little bit, yeah.
So the Rochester Zebras won the toss. They have elected to defer to the second half, which means the North Miami Warriors and Mr. Jacob White will start first for the North Miami Warriors. Again, Jacob White comes in with a rushing total of about 700 yards in the TRC.
North Miami offensive starters tonight.
Yeah.
Quarterback, Jacob White, as Dave said. Fullback, Will Miller. Your halfback is number 18, Trevor Lynn. Your tailback is Evan Sumner. Your split end is Will Meixel. Your tight end is Dakota Ribble. And your five linemen are Skylar Wilson, Lane Eckro, Kevin Huffman, Avery Lynn, and Evan Beach. Your defensive starters for the Rochester Zebras, who are taking the field first, would be Wes Beck, Jordan Schaefer, and Otto Shabani is your three linemen. Your linebackers are Wilson Lee, Connor McLaughlin, Jacob Hadashell, Tanner Music, and Jay Heckerthorn. Your two corners tonight, Gavin Bennett, John Hunting, and your lone safety is junior Brett Abbott.
So the Rochester Zebras will start on defense first.
It's
the North Miami Warriors. Yeah, go ahead.
I was like, it's kind of like homecoming week for you, isn't it?
It is, absolutely. They rolled the red carpet out.
I swear, you're in a parade. You're waving to the right. You're waving to the left. We just give you.
Andy's wearing red colors.
Yeah, we just need to put a sash around him. We got a parade marshal
yeah,
here.
Well, I'm telling you, red just happened to be one of the warmest colors in my closet, so that's what I grabbed. So Wilson Lee to kick back deep. The deep man is White. Stands back at about as a 5-10-yard line. Wilson Lee high under over again kick. Good kickoff. White runs it down at about the 7-yard line. Slips, gets back up. Now at the 20, slips a tackle at the 22, and then wrestled down at about the 23-yard line. So that's where the North Miami Warriors will start first, going to our left and with the wind.
Yeah, that's a good thing for anybody tonight. That wind is going to play a little bit of havoc, I think, on passing and kicking tonight.
So again, senior Jacob White has the play from the sideline. And I know last week they ran a lot out of that shotgun formation, and we'll probably see that again tonight as well. So it'll be first and 10 for North Miami at their own 22-yard line. Wide to the right side is Meixel. Ribble wide to the near side, out of the shotgun. Nope, under center now is White. White takes a snap. Hands off, right up the middle. Goes, looks like Sumner. Evan Sumner crosses the 30 to about the 32-yard line. Nice start for the senior Evan Sumner and the North Miami Warriors, as that's close to a first down. In fact, it is. Give him 10. It'll be a first down for the Warriors.
The game is good for North Miami. First down.
So the ball in the near hash. The Warriors going to our left, and it's first and 10 for North Miami as they break the huddle. They'll send Meixel wide to the near side. Under center is White, two flankers. In motion is Sumner to the right. On the option right up the middle is the fullback, Will Miller. And Miller carries the ball to about the 35-yard line.
It's going to be brought down by Wes Beck.
Get a pickup of about 2. It'll be second down and 8. Again, early in the contest here at North Miami High School. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering. I'm David Musselman. Second and 8 for North Miami, just shy of their own 35-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. White under center. Sumner comes in motion to the near side. Gives to the freshman, I believe. That was
Miller.
Make that the sophomore, Lynn.
Okay.
Trevor Lynn, the sophomore, gets the carry over the right side. And he gets it out to the 39-yard line. It's the third down and 4 for the Warriors at their own 38. Ball in the middle of the field going to our left. Jacob White under center. Wide to the near side is Meixel. Ribble split right. Ball in the middle of the field. Third and 4 for the Warriors. Under center is White. Back to pass. Looks right. Throws right. He's got a receiver. It is complete on the far sideline to Ribble. And Ribble's driven out of bounds at about his own 44-yard line. So that'll be a pickup of about 6 yards and another Warrior first down.
Dakota Ribble, the tight end, is not hard to find.
Jeez, no, he's the tallest one on the field.
Yeah, 6'5", 195 pounds. So expect White, if the ball's in the air, it might be going to Ribble a lot.
First and 10 for the Warriors at their own 44. White and the Warriors on the football. 10:20 to play first quarter, no score. Pitch goes to Sumner, coming to the near side. Rochester strings it out. Sumner crosses the 45, gets to the 46, giving 2 yards. It'll be second and 8. I'm not sure if you want to go east-west on the Rochester defense right up the middle. You know, Rochester, over the last several games, have really been beaten up on the front line, or at least early on in games.
Yeah, you're right. The opponents have had a lot of luck opening holes between the tackles for Rochester, against Rochester. And, you know, with Rochester's speed in the backfield and their linebacker core, you're not too many people are going to outrun them on the corner.
Yeah. Second and 8 on the option. White keeps around the near side, runs away from Schaefer. Now into Rochester territory, down the near sideline. Spin move gets him out to the Rochester 35-yard line, giving him the 36. It'll be first and 10 for the Warriors.
And just as I say that, Jacob White comes around the corner and picks up, 15 yards?
Enough for another North Miami first down as he gets out to the Rochester 35. Again, North Miami going to our left. No score here at North Miami High School. 9.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. But the Warriors on their first possession driving nicely. So the Warriors break the huddle. They send Michael wide to the right side, wide to the left side. Is Ribble. White under center. The fullback behind him is Miller. White takes a snap. Gives to Sumner. Sumner goes left and stood up after about a 2 or 3 yard gain. Not a lot there for the running backs, Evan Sumner. As he gets to, it'll be second and 8 as the clock rolls with 9:05 to play in the first quarter.
The Zebras are switching to a 4-4 defense now, bringing down linebacker Tanner Music to play defensive tackle.
I think that's a good move.
I like it too. Mm-hmm.
Second down and 8 for the Warriors at the Rochester 34-yard line. Mikesell and Ribble now goes wide to the right side. Jacob White under center. Sumner in motion. The fullback Miller gets it off the right side. Miller, a huge hole right up the middle. He pushes a pile inside the 25 down to around the 23. Another Warrior first down.
Warrior offense right now doing anything they want to do. Their front five is getting a good push on the Zebra front four. And it's giving plenty of time for White to throw or Miller, Lynn, and Sumner to run in the backfield.
10-yard gain for Sumner right up the middle. And now the ball spotted inside the Rochester 25-yard line at about the 24. It'll be first and 10 for the Warriors. Ball in the middle of the field. North Miami will send Mikesell and Ribble wide to the right side. Wing back to the left is Sumner. Wing back to the right is Lynn. Your fullback is Miller. Jacob White sets the line of scrimmage with 4 on the play clock. Lynn comes in motion to the near side. A busted play. White tries to get away from the defense, and he's going to be stacked up at the 25-yard line. He'll lose a yard. It'll bring up second down and 11. I think that was a busted play. The fullback went one way, and White went another. And I think he was just running for his life to the near side, and he loses a yard or two. It'll bring up second down and 12. 7:50 to play. First quarter, no score here in North Miami. And the Warriors putting together a drive here on the first series of the contest. Second down and 12 for the Warriors. As Ribble goes wide to the right side, Mikesell wide to the near side, short side of the field. Jacob White under center on second and 12. From the Rochester 26, back to pass, looks right, throws right, and over the head, believe it or not, of Ribble, it'll be third down and 12. That ball, I think, got into that jet stream and floated a little bit right over the head of Ribble.
I think you're right. He had some pressure coming from the left side of the defensive line, and he was trying to get it up over the outstretched hands, and in doing so, he got it up over his receiver as well.
Trav, you played defense, third and 12. Pin your ears back and just go?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you got to assume pass. I mean, if Zebras are on offense, maybe a screen. I don't know if North Miami has that. But the front four need to get in there quick.
Third down and 12 for the Warriors at the Rochester 26-yard line. Two receivers, one to the right, one to the left. In motion is Lynn. Now back to on the option. White keeps it, flips it to the near side to Sumner. He grabs the bad pitch. And then Rochester right there to bring him down after a 2-yard loss. So that'll bring up fourth down and 14.
North Miami lucky to get that ball back.
Yeah, you're right.
Rochester right there covered the pitch really well, and that pitch was high and behind Lynn, and he did a good job of just corralling it and keeping it from turning into a fumble.
The Warriors do have a pretty good kicker in Jacob Stiver. It does not look like he will attempt a field goal here. It'll be fourth down and 14 for North Miami at the Rochester 28-yard line. Michael goes wide to the right side, the wide side of the field. Ribble wide to the near side. Under center is White. Sumner in motion, back to pass is right, rolls to the right side. White throws down the far sideline, and it is incomplete. I think the receiver on that far side fell down. I think maybe that was Meixel that fell down. So Rochester will hold and take over on downs, and it'll be first and 10 for the Z's at their own 28-yard line, now going to our right, which is basically into the wind. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Final game of the regular season, Zebras looking to run the table in the TRC, and they'll have the football for the first time tonight, starting at their own 28 on the near hash, going to our right. So Bennett will be your tight end left, Kistler your tight end right, the flanker to the right is Heckathorn, and under center is Hunting. John with split backs behind him, sends Heckathorn to motion. He gets a pitch going left, end blockers in front. Heckathorn cuts it upfield, not a lot there. Good pursuit by the North Miami defense. Might have gotten to the 30. I'm not sure where they're going to mark that. Actually, they're going to mark that as no gain. Give him the 28, nothing on it. It'll be second and 10.
Yeah, he had a blocker out in front, but he just couldn't get around the defensive end for North Miami, who did a great job of staying home and eluding the block and making the tackle.
6:20 to play, first quarter. No score here at North Miami. The Zebras of the football the first time tonight. They look at second down and 10 from their own 28-yard line. Bennett comes wide to the near side. Flanker to the left is Abbott. High backs for Hunting. Abbott comes in motion to the near side. The handoff goes to Hadashell. Hadashell lowers his head, crosses the 30, gets to the 31. A pickup of 3. It'll bring up third down and 7. It'll be interesting here to see what Rochester does, basically going into that 20-25 mile an hour wind. But we have seen all year that slant to Bennett has been open every time.
And looking at the defensive starters for North Miami, their backs are 5'10", 5'9", 5'6", 5'7". So.
But you also have Ribble back there as a strong safety at 6'5".
Well, he was my last guy I was going to say.
I see. High backs for Rochester. 3rd and 7. Back to passes Hunting. Here comes a little pressure. He steps up, floats the ball to the near side. Heckathorn is complete. Heckathorn driven out of bounds at the 42-yard line. That's enough for a Zebra first down. Nice comeback route by Jay Heckathorn. Nice job by Hunting, putting it on the spot where Heckathorn's going to end up on the comeback. And he gets out to the 41-yard line and a Zebra first down.
Ribble followed Bennett the entire time there, and I don't even know if Hunting looked at Bennett's side on the left.
Yeah.
He looked right the whole time and hoping to hit Heckathorn like he did.
So it'll be 1st and 10 for the Zebras at their own 41-yard line. Ball in the near hash, which is the North Miami sideline. Rochester going to our right. Bennett comes wide to the near side. Flanker to the left is Heckathorn. Flanker to the right is Hadashell. Beck is your lone back. Hunting under center on 1st and 10. Hadashell goes in motion to the left. Here's the snap. Gives to Hadashell. Make the Heckathorn on the end around. Heckathorn down the near sideline. Shakes the tackler. And then ran out of bounds. Heckathorn had one person to beat, and that was the sideline. If he could have stayed in bounds, he'd have been gone. He does take the ball inside the North Miami 40-yard line, down to around the 38. That's another Zebra first down.
His momentum just carried him out to the sideline. He couldn't keep it in bounds.
1st and 10 for Rochester at the North Miami 37-yard line. Again, the Zebras going to our right. 5:15 to play in the first quarter. No score here at North Miami.
22 on the pickup by Heckathorn.
Well, they've been waiting for him to have a huge game all year long.
Yeah, they have.
Abbott wide to the left side. Kistler and Bennett tight ends. I-backs for Rochester. Hadashell gets the carry going left. Tries to kick it out. Now cuts it back inside. Gets it inside the 35-yard line and driven backwards as he gets it to the 35. Pickup of about 2. And it'll be 2nd and 8 for the Zebras.
And I don't think it's any secret that Hadashell's on top of everybody's scouting report. So you kind of like to see Heckathorn and Beck get off to a good start at the beginning of the ball game, because that's only going to help Jacob Hadashell as the game runs on.
Here's the other thing to me. You know Tanner Hughes is on pace to have a huge game tonight against Tippecanoe Valley.
Yeah.
So with that being said, is Hadashell going to get the ball to keep that lead, that rushing lead?
He'll still get his 20 carries, I believe.
2nd and 8. Pitch goes to Hadashell. He's got Wes Beck in front of him. Hadashell really patient. Cuts it back inside. Not outside. Looks to forearm a tackler, and Hadashell gets it close to the 20 of North Miami. And the spot on the near side, maybe the 21, that'll be enough for a Zebra first down. That was outstanding running by Hadashell, who never went to full speed. He let the blocks develop in front of him, picked his way through the defense, and got it out to the 20.
And he got some good blocks from West Beck out there in front.
Yeah, he had West Beck in front, and then pulling guard Tanner Music also blocking him.
17-yard gain for Jacob Houdeshell, and it's first and 10 for Rochester at the North Miami 20-yard line. They'll go two tight ends in the straight T backfield. Abbott back there as well. Hunting under center. Here's the snap. Gives to Houdeshell again, going right. Houdeshell pushing the pile forward to about the 16, giving four. It'll be second down and six for the Warriors. And one thing that we've already seen a lot tonight is Brett Abbott in the backfield.
Yeah, he's playing a lot of flanker position. I don't know whether, you know, I think, what was it, Tippy Valley? We saw a halfback pass out of that, but it was Houdeshell that threw it. You know, Abbott's got an arm on him. He's got a cannon, so I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see that again before this is all over.
Heckathorn brings the play in from the sideline. 15 on the play clock for the Rochester Zebras. 3:45 to play, first quarter. Rochester has it second and six from the North Miami 16-yard line. Bennett split right. Flanker to the left side is Heckathorn. Here's the snap. Houdeshell gets it right up the middle. Jacob, spin move, pushes his way inside the 15, still pushing his way down to around the 11. And a pickup of about 5 yards, which brings up third down, giving him the 12. It'll be third down at about two for Rochester with 3:15 to play in the first quarter.
Something I noticed on that one play by Houdeshell where he picked up the 17 there on the four-yard gain he had previous to this last one. When he came to the right, the North Miami defense, everybody moved to the right of the field. The counter would be wide open.
That's right. Third and two for Rochester. In motion comes Houdeshell to the near side. From the North Miami 12, here's a snap. West Beck right up the middle. Beck hit at the line of scrimmage. And maybe to the 11, it's going to be fourth and one for the Rochester Zebras at the North Miami 11-yard line. Going to our right with 2:45 to play in the first quarter. No score here at North Miami.
So I know in the past, the Rochester Zebras, they switch their plays by the flanker, bringing it in and out. Usually this year, it's been the tight end between Shane and Kistler, but Shane's been on the sideline the entire night. It's been Kistler, so that's why Abbott is coming into the game to bring the plays for flanker position. And Heckathorn to switch.
Fourth and one for the Zebras at the North Miami 11. Full house backfield. Heckathorn gets a carry going left. He's got a first down. His spin move gets him inside the 5-yard line, down to around the 1 or 2. So it's going to be first and goal for the Zebras inside the 5. Nice job that time by Jacob Houdeshell and the guys up front clearing a hole.
Yeah, that whole left side, Lane Coffey, Tanner Music, then your center, Adam Basham.
And one thing that we probably won't see tonight, or one guy we won't see tonight, is Ariel Harper, who's still battling that knee injury.
Yeah, I know last week Coach Sanders said that they were hoping to get him to go this week, but I guess he had a rough practice with his turns and everything. So, I mean, no need to waste him, though, until next week if first down of sectionals at Twin Lakes.
I beg your pardon, it's at the 6. Well, if that was a goal line, it is at the 6, I'm sorry. So it'll be first and goal at the 6 for Rochester. Now, Hunting will have to use a timeout. We'll take a 30. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WRLI. 1:56 to play in the first quarter. Rochester has the football. First and goal from the North Miami 6 going to our right. It hasn't been flashy. It hasn't been trick plays. It's just been grinded out by Beck, Heckathorn, and Houdeshell.
With both teams running the ball predominantly, only passing really when they had to.
Yeah, one pass, right?
Yeah. And, you're not going to get a whole lot of opportunities tonight with the football, so you better make the most of it when you get them.
And something else we haven't said all year is no penalty so far in the first quarter.
Travis,
knock on wood.
What are you doing? So Rochester has two tight ends, Bennett left, Kistler right, full house backfield. Heckathorn goes in motion to the left side. From the 6, Beck gets the carry going right up the middle, and Beck falls across the 5 to the 4, giving him 2. It'll be second and goal from the 4. Boy, North Miami doing a great job up front, just blowing up our front line. There is no place to run between the tackles right now.
They're doing a good job of filling the gaps. Rochester trying to fire out straight ahead, North Miami sliding off to the side. Yeah. Everybody filling a gap.
90 seconds to play in the first quarter. No score here at North Miami. The Zebras have it second and goal from the 4. They'll break the huddle with 13 on the play clock. They'll go to that 2 tight end, full house backfield look again. Bennett tight left, Kistler tight right. Houdeshell, Beck, and Abbott in the backfield left to right. Abbott goes in motion to the left side. Hunting takes the snap, gives to Houdeshell going right. Houdeshell lowers his head, looking for the end zone. No signal yet. Touchdown, Zebras.
Nope.
Jacob Houdeshell, 4-yard run, puts the Zebras on the board first, 6-0.
Nice job by Jacob Houdeshell. Like David said, just put his head down and kept the legs churning until he crossed the goal line.
So the Rochester Zebras strike first, and Wilson Lee will come in. He'll be kicking into that 20-mile-an-hour wind, looking for the extra point here with 1:09 to play in the first quarter. Again, Rochester up 6-0 with the PAT coming. Man, he looked really, really good in the pregame, did Wilson Lee. Abbott is your holder. Here we go. Snap is back, hold is down. Wilson Lee puts a right foot into it, and it is good. 7-0 Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. A minute 9 to play in the first quarter. The Zebra strike first, Trav.
Yes, sir. 12 plays, 72 yards, capped off by a Jacob Hadeshell 4-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebras lead 7-0 with the buck 09 remaining in the first quarter.
Back deep to receive the kick from the North Miami, from the Rochester Zebras, Shane Holden. Also Lynn and White back deep as Wilson Lee will kick off. Brad Thomas, David Musselman, Travis Watering, thanks for joining us here this evening. Final game of the regular season. Next week on the road as we go to Monticello to battle Twin Lakes. 7-0, Rochester on top. The ball falls off the tee. We'll try her again. So Rochester kicking into the wind. My nephew, Evan Exmeyer, is down under the goalpost. Almost caught that last field goal or extra point. Lee, that would make that
drop.
White loses the football. The ball's still loose. North Miami jumps on it. And actually, we're going to rule him down at the 20. Wow. Well, there was no. I think White just lost control of the ball. He lost in the lights or something. He did not catch it cleanly, and he was fortunate to pick it up at about his 20-yard line. So North Miami will start there with the Zebras leading 7-0 with a minute 4 to play in the first quarter. North Miami will start this drive on their own 20. White brings the club to the line of scrimmage. Jacob Stiver wide to the near side. Miller is your fullback. Jacob White under center on first and 10. Lynn goes in motion, on the option, pitches it out to Lynn. Lynn coming to the near side, Zebras closing fast. Abbott grabs him around the shoulder pads and rips him down. But I believe he got about 4 or 5 on the play.
Judging by some of those pitches so far we've seen on that option, I have a feeling one of these could be a fumble eventually there. He's barely getting them off, and then when he does, who's ever catching it is bobbling a little bit. He was able to, like you said, though, to get 4 or 5 yards on the play.
So he got 5. Did Trevor Lynn, and a second down upcoming for the North Miami Warriors. Ball in the near hash going to our left with 30 seconds to play in the first quarter. Again, Rochester leading 7-0. Stiver wide to the near side, Ribbles wide right. Another receiver in there as well for North Miami, I believe is Lynn on the option. White keeps it over the right side. Jacob White carries the ball across the North Miami 35, down to around the 37, another Warrior first down.
He'll pick up 12 on that carry.
17 seconds to play. Miami, in the first quarter, the Warriors with the football at their own 37-yard line, going to our left. The clock starts, and I'm not sure the Warriors will run another play in this quarter. They will not. After one, the Rochester Zebras lead North Miami 7-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Going to the second quarter here in North Miami, the Zebras leading 7-0. It was a quick first quarter. Both teams basically with the football just once. North Miami kept it half the quarter. Rochester kept it the other half. And now North Miami with on first and 10 from their own 37 with the football here to start the second. Here's a pitch to Sumner. Sumner has a blocker in front of him, is spun down as he crosses the 40, giving him the 41, a pickup of 4. It'll be second down and 6. I'd like to thank Higgins Bestmart out of Denver for supplying the pregame snacks for us.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they have that you're still eating.
They have, okay, how's yours sitting right there?
It's good, I'm looking at it.
We've had some nice ham and cheese, turkey and cheese.
Right on, right on.
And Must is still waiting for the pizza at halftime.
Right on. Second and 6 for North Miami at their own 41. Ball in the near hash. Ribble wide to the near side. Jacob White looks up and down the line of scrimmage. Has the play. Sets the club on second and 6. Sumner comes in motion to the near side. On the option. Miller right up the middle. Miller a huge hole. Carries it into Rochester territory. Down around the 48-yard line. That's another first down for the North Miami Warriors.
And to finish this sandwich, you usually need a drink to wash it down.
Yeah,
so if anybody on the Rochester side is listening, I will gladly accept a hot chocolate. I'm 0 for 2 this year. I'm thinking third time's a charm.
Yeah.
You're more than welcome to bring one up right here, and I'll take it.
Well, that's good of you. First and 10 for the Warriors at the Rochester 48.
And Muscle pay you back.
White quickly over center. takes the ball going left. Jacob White pushing the pile forward. Maybe gets to the 45. Giving three, it'll be second and seven.
He's doing an outstanding job holding onto the ball there. You can tell the first Zebra, I can't tell who it was to hit him, but Wes Beck was doing everything he had to strip that ball from him.
Actually, give him the 46, fellas. It'll be second down and eight after a two-yard carry. The one thing about Jacob White is one Zebra is not going to bring him down. You're going to have to hold on for dear life and hope to get some help.
Right.
Second and eight for the Warriors. Shy of the Zebra, 45. Stiver wide to the near side. Sumner goes in motion to the left. He gets a pitch going left. Sumner then cuts it upfield. Sumner off to the races, and he's caught from behind, but not until he gets to the Rochester 35. Give him 10. Actually, give him 11. It'll be first and 10 for the Warriors.
I think Evan Sumner just gets lost back there in the backfield. We have him at 5'7", 130 pounds. It's hard to see him sometimes when he's running out there.
Starting to see a theme, though, from the North Miami offense as they're attacking these corners.
Give him the 34. It'll be first and 10 for the Warriors. Ball on the far hash. They're on the football again. 10 minutes to play. First half, Rochester up 7-0. Jacob White sets a line. Lynn comes in motion to the near side. Back to passes White. Right before he hits hit, he throws it. It's complete to Sumner. Sumner cuts it back inside, cuts it back outside of the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Warriors!
Nope. Yep.
Jacob White to Evan Sumner on a 34-yard touchdown pass, and it's 7-6.
Well, that time the Rochester Zebras found themselves one man short as Sumner finds himself wide open on the sideline. He catches the ball and puts a move towards the middle of the field to get behind a block downfield and gets to the end zone.
So the PAT coming. Lynn is your holder. Stiver's the kicker. Snap is back. Hold is down. Kick is blocked. And it's 7-6, Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Welcome back to the Rochester Zebras. North Miami struck to score a touchdown. 7 plays, 80 yards. White to Summers for a 34-yard touchdown. The PAT was blocked by Jay Heckathorn. 9:53 remaining in the second quarter.
Now it'll be interesting to see what North Miami does here. Do you kick the 23? I don't know. I think if I was the opposing team, I'd just kick it out of bounds.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
Yeah, kick it out of bounds. Try and kick the that second row.
The second row is Abbott and Hadashell.
Yeah, pick your poison.
Back deep
and Bennett. Yeah.
Heckathorn.
Let's go out of bounds.
Yeah, I think I'd probably try to onside kick it right here. Stiver ready to kick. 7-6 Rochester. 9:53 to play in the first half. Rochester will get the football for the second time this evening. Stiver kicks it deep and drives Heckathorn back to about the 12. Heckathorn at the middle of the 20, the 25, and is grabbed and drove backwards as he gets across the 25, maybe to the 26. So North Miami's kickoff team did a great job focusing in on number 23.
Yeah, and right now, just like we saw in a couple games earlier this year, North Miami playing with more heart and enthusiasm than I think what the Zebras are.
And they're fans. They're still into it. They're loud. They have their cowbells, their horns.
You're kidding. I hadn't heard that.
I love the atmosphere.
First and 10 for the Zebras at the 24-yard line. Bennett wide to the near side, which is the wide side of the field. Flanker to the right is Heckathorn. I-backs for Hunting. John under center from his 24. First and 10. There's a snap. Wes Beck right up the middle. Beck pushing the pile ahead. Is cut down at about the 28. So a pickup about 4. It'll be second down and near 6 for Rochester with 9.5 minutes to play in the first half.
Score update from the TRC. Southwood 14, Wabash 0.
Yeah, I'd really hate to be the Wabash Apaches this week.
Yeah.
After Southwood takes one on the chin last week against Northfield. Ugh. Second and 6. Twins to the near side for Rochester. Beck gets the carry right up the middle. Hurdles the line of scrimmage. Beck then takes about three or four North Miami tacklers out to the 35-yard line. And another Zebra first down as he picks up 7 on the play.
Wes Beck and Jacob White have a lot in common. Not one person can bring him down. They need help.
I'm guessing he is a load.
Guessing the Rochester coaches upstairs took note of when the Twins came to the near side, only one defender came out to cover him.
I saw that. I saw you pointing out there.
First and 10 for Rochester at their own 35. Ball in the middle of the field. Heckathorn and Bennett wide to the near side. Now they do have two
defenders.
Yeah, defenders corners out here on them. I-backs for Hunting. John pitches to Hadashell, going to the left. Hadashell cuts it up the field. Hadashell in near Northway territory. Hadashell then caught from behind as he is driven out of bounds at about the 43 and a Zebra first down.
He had an outstanding block by Wes Beck, which gave him all that green to run with.
So Hadashell carries it to the North Miami 43-yard line with 8:43 to play. In the first half, the Rochester Zebras leading 7-6. Again, a week number 9 of the high school football season.
The season flew, felt like.
Yeah, it has.
It was fast.
It has flown, you're right. Heckathorn and Bennett wide to the right side. Still one defender out there. Now the second one comes out for North Miami. I-backs for Hunting. John to Beck up the middle. Wes Beck hit at the 40. They're flagging the play, pushes the pile ahead to the 41-yard line. But again, there is a flag on the play. 8:24 to play, first half, 7-6 Rochester. Wes Beck carries the ball for 3 yards, but what is the play? Well, no, it's going to be against the Zebras
against
on the hold.
Zebras.
And I got a feeling that one came from the far side. That was a receiver that committed that hold out there near the Rochester sideline. Ugh. So that's going to back up, back the Zebras up to their 49. 7-8. Second down, make that first and 18 now for Rochester. Go! 8:24 to play in the first half, 7-6 Rochester. The Zebras break the huddle. They'll send Bennett and Heckathorn wide to the right side. Shane now in the game, tight left, eye backs for Hunting. John on first and 18, fakes a handoff, back to pass, looks right, throws right. He's got a streaking Heckathorn down the far sideline, and the wind held it up just enough that Lynn makes a great play down that far sideline to break the pass up. It'll bring up second down and 18. If he's throwing with no wind, if he's throwing with the wind, that's a touchdown because Heckathorn had 5 steps on Lynn.
Heckathorn had the steps. I don't know if Hunting's got the arm to get it down that far downfield, especially in this kind of a wind.
Yeah.
And we saw where he came up short. But
8:06 to play, first half, 7-6. Rochester on top. Hey, Greg. The ball at the Rochester 49 on the near hash. Heckathorn and Bennett goes wide to the right side again. Tied into the right is Kistler. I-backs for Hunting. On second and 18, John under center takes a snap, back to pass again. A little screen, flips it out here to Heckathorn. And make that Hadashell, and Hadashell's driven backwards.
Yeah, that never did set up very good for the Zebras. They
well,
had
because,
one blocker out there in front of Hadashell, but 3 defenders coming that way.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you who blew that up. For North Miami,
it
was Lane Eckroat was in the backfield and in Hunting's face before, like Brad said, really had an opportunity to set that up properly, and that pass was dropped Rochester back to their own 41. With 7:42 to play in the first half, Rochester leading 7-6, so that'll bring up third down at about 29-25 now for the Zs.
And after the big 31-yard gain by Hadashell, they've gone backwards.
Yeah. From Rochester's 41, Heckathorn goes in motion to the right side. Here's the snap. Back to pass again is Hunting. Hunting steps up, throws down the right side. It's complete to Heckathorn. Heckathorn has 15 yards as he gets back to the original line of scrimmage. That'll bring up fourth down and 10. And I've got a feeling Rochester might just play field position here and punt this one away.
I agree. Get it back, pin North Miami back up against their own goal line.
Give him 15 yards on the pitch and catch. And it'll be fourth down and about 11 now for the Rochester Zebras, and it does look like that they'll come on to punt the ball away as the ball now at the Rochester 44-yard line with 6:52 to play in the first half, and Wes Beck, Wes Beck will line up to punt. Don't forget the up man is the backup quarterback in Brett Abbott.
And they completed this last week as well.
I don't know, 11 yards now, fellas, though.
You're right.
Got Beck ready to kick, you. Stands inside his 45. Abbott stands at midfield, fourth and 11. And we're going to have a false start. Oh, no false start. Bad snap. West Beck picks it up. It's blocked. And now it flies towards North Miami's end zone. And North Miami picks it up. North Miami recovers the blocked punt back at the 19.
Abbott kind of stuck his hand out like he wanted to catch that football.
I think that might have been a fake.
And it went through his hand and in the process bounced off of Beck's hands. And he picked it up. He probably should have just run or thrown it, but he tried to kick it. And in doing so, North Miami blocked it. The ball went straight backwards towards their end zone.
I mean, it went backwards.
It went backwards like
air.
A cannon.
Yeah.
I couldn't tell if Abbott was just trying to do a nice fake or actually snag the ball. His hands were in the air, ready for the ball, it looked like.
Yeah.
Well, what should have happened on that play, it didn't, as Heckathorn was should have been flagged for a false start, and they didn't whistle it.
Yeah.
So now it'll be first and 10 for North Miami at the Rochester 19-yard line, going to our right. Sumner comes in motion to the near side. Back to pass is White, looking for the dagger over the middle of the field. It's complete to Ribble. Ribble fighting for the end zone.
He's going to be short.
And he is going to be short, but he does pick up 18 yards. It'll be first and goal for North Miami at the Rochester 1.
Great job by North Miami, not only defensively and driving Rochester backwards and keep forcing them to punt, but then getting the fake punt. And on the first play of the offense, just about putting it in the end zone.
First and goal for the Warriors at the Rochester 1-yard line with 6:10 to play in the first half. Rochester up 7-6, but I got a feeling that might be about to change. Jacob White under center. Miller behind him. White takes a snap, goes over the left side of the line, looking for the end zone. No signal yet. There it is. Touchdown. Jacob White puts the Warriors on the board at 13 to make that 12-7 with 6 minutes to play in the first half.
And Coach Zahner's fears are coming to fruition here in the first half of this football game as North Miami has taken complete control of this football game here in the second quarter.
So North Miami now up 12-7.
Go for two.
And a two-point conversion coming for the Warriors. So White brings a club to the line of scrimmage. Lynn and Meixel goes wide to the left side. Tight right is Ribble. Under center is White. And now we're going to have a North Miami timeout. 6 minutes to play in the first half. Warriors will take a timeout. We will too. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI.
Welcome back to the second quarter of Zebra North Miami. North Miami does strike again. White with a 1-yard touchdown run, and the Warriors right now are lining up for the 2-point conversion to try to take a 7-point lead over the Zebras.
Meixel wide to the right side. Ribbles wide left, or kind of in the slot to the left side. Jacob White looks up and down the line of scrimmage, tailback or wing back to the right. Is Sumner. Is that Lynn there to the flanker to the left, to the wing back to the left? It is. Miller is also in there as a fullback.
Must be waiting for TV to come back from timeout because the referee's standing over the ball.
So 2-point conversion attempt coming up for North Miami, looking to go up, like Trav said, 14-7. As White's ready, he gets a green light, now steps under center, sets the line of scrimmage. Sumner goes in motion to the left. He gets a pitch going left. Sumner cuts it back inside, looking for the end zone. Untouched in the end zone for two. It is good. 14-7, North Miami. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Back in North Miami, 6 minutes to play in the first half. Trav, turnovers result in points.
Absolutely, and after a turnover from the Zebras, North Miami strikes with two plays, 20 yards. White with a 1-yard touchdown run. The 2-point conversion was good. North Miami takes the lead, 14-7, with 6 minutes remaining in the second quarter.
Back deep to receive the Stiver kick will be Abbott to the left. In the middle is Hadashell. To the right is Heckathorn. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering. I'm David Musselman. Well, I don't know what y'all thought, but I knew that this was going to be a tough football game. North Miami much, much better than 1-7.
Yeah, you're right. I think Coach Zahner was afraid of that as well.
Stiver kicks it deep. Hadashell boots it, picks up by Abbott, and then hands off to Heckathorn. Heckathorn down the right sideline. Heckathorn with nobody in front of him. Cuts it back in, and then he's grabbed by the shoestrings at the 50-yard line. So he returns at about 30 yards and gives Rochester pretty good field position here to start their third series at midfield.
Boy, that was crazy. Hadashell botched it, handed it to Abbott. Abbott nope. Handed it to Heckathorn.
That's what I was watching.
Hadashell botched it. Abbott picked it up, handed it off to Heckathorn, and he's going right.
I was looking down to my paper, and I heard three different names. I didn't know what
you're
to
right.
think.
So the Zebras on the football, middle of the field. Bennett and Heckathorn wide to the near side. Wes Beck and Jacob Hadashell in the I formation, hunting under center from midfield. On first and 10, John takes a snap, hands off to Beck. Beck driven backwards. He's going to lose a yard. It'll be second and 11.
I'll tell you what, this North Miami football team is fired up. Rochester better figure out and find some intensity or it's going to be a long night for the Zebras.
Second and 11. The offense in the last two series, Brad, has gone backwards.
They have. Like I said, Hadashell had a big 30-yard gain, and then after that it was 10-yard loss, 5-yard loss, 10-yard loss, and then the blocked punt.
Five and a half to play, first half. North Miami up 14-7. Hunting back to pass, two-step drop, throws right down the far sideline, and out there to receiving the catch, or trying to receive the catch, is Bennett, and he throws it out of bounds, and that'll bring up third and 11 for the Zebras.
Somebody needs to tell Hunting that there's a 25-mile-an-hour wind blowing out of the west. He's got to get that ball a little closer to the ground when he throws it downfield.
He never gave Bennett the chance, and it's unfortunate because that Craig Armstrong, who was, or Cade Armstrong, who was on Bennett, is 5'9", 175. Yep. At least give Bennett a chance to out-jump him.
Going to have to throw a frozen rope tonight. You can't throw them ball high lofting passes.
Or maybe a slant.
Yeah.
Third and 11, two wideouts, back to pass as Hunting rolls to the near side. Hunting steps up now, throws it to Heckathorn. Heckathorn complete inside the North Miami 40, shakes a tackler, gets to the 30, still on his feet inside the 30-yard line, and driven out of bounds at about the 28. That's a huge third down play for the Zebras, as Heckathorn did a great job, who caught the ball at about the 44, 45-yard line, and then North Miami tried to push him out of bounds, tight rope the sideline, got it inside the 30, down to the 28.
That time, Hunting did a much better job throwing the ball, a lot tighter spiral, a lot less loft to it.
That comeback pass, the route by Heckathorn, has worked now twice in a row.
You're right, and Heckathorn did a great job of staying in bounds and avoiding tackles and getting upfield.
First and 10 of the North Miami 28. Rochester on the football. Hunting pitches out to Heckathorn going right. Heckathorn cuts it back in to make the Hadashell back inside. Hadashell looking for the end zone at the 5, looking for the goal line. Touchdown Zebras on a 28-yard run by Jacob Hadashell.
Nice job there by Jake Hadashell. He got some blocks on that right side of the Rochester line. He cut back against the grain as North Miami over-pursued on defense. And Hadashell, once he cut back, there was nobody left between him and the end zone.
4:55 to play in the second quarter. Rochester within one now. It's 14-13. And Wilson Lee on to attempt the extra point and tie this football game up. Aperture holder. Snap is back, hold is down, kick is away, nice high kick, and it is good. We're tied at 14 with 4:55 to play in the first half. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 4:55 to play in the first half, Trav. We're all knotted up.
Four plays, 50 yards, capped off by a Jacob Hadashell 28-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was perfect. Zebras knotted up 14-14 with, like you said, 4:55 to play in the first half.
Jay Heckathorn with a 30-yard return to set him up on the 50, and then the big 22-yard catch to set up Hadashell from the 28.
And I felt Rochester really needed to answer that.
Yeah, they did.
Lynn takes the football inside the 20 and is brought down before he gets to the 30 by Abbott.
This is a big series for both offensively and defensively. I mean, let's just say Zebras holding a 3-and-out. They have 4 minutes to score and get the ball back in the third half.
Well, let's baby steps.
If North Miami can travel the field again.
We got an update score from Tippecanoe Valley. They lead Whitco 8-6 in the first quarter.
Huh?
Yeah. Tippecanoe Valley leading Whitco 8-6.
Somebody didn't. Really?
Why, you hear something different?
No, I just can't believe it.
Oh. Well, it's still early in the game.
So Jacob White under center. We're tied at 14.
Whitco might be in a trap game this week, too.
Yeah, you're right. You're exactly right. Miller shakes a tackler at the line of scrimmage. Miller pops it into the outside. Miller at the 40 and carries it out to the 41 of his own 41-yard line. Pickup of 13 yards and a Warrior first down.
So the freshman Miller doing a great job. That's his third run, his fourth run tonight. Three of them for over 10 yards. So he's got 34 yards and four carries.
First and 10 for the Warriors at their own 41. Ball in the near hash. Ribbles a wide out to the left side. Mike's a wide out to the near side. Flanker to the right is Sumner. The left is, now Sumner goes in motion left. The carry goes to Lynn. And Lynn is hit hard at the line. Gets a couple as he falls forward to the 43. Give him two. It'll be second and 8.
Wilson Lee for the Zebras on the stop.
4.5 minutes to play. The first half, we're tied at 14 here at North Miami High School. Brad Thomas, Travis Watchering. I'm David Musselman. And we are seeing a type of game that I anticipated seeing.
Yeah. Both teams running the ball very well, sprinkling in just enough passes to keep the defense honest.
Yep.
And back and forth ball game right now.
Not a lot of possessions by either team in this first half. As we have 4:10 to play here in the first half, it'll be second down and 8 for North Miami, their own 43. Sumner comes in motion to the near side. On the option right up the middle is Miller. Miller now in Rochester territory, brought down to the 47. Another Warrior first down as he picks up 9 yards and carries it out to the Zebra 47-yard line.
He might be a freshman, but he's not running like a freshman tonight.
No.
You He is running by a seasoned veteran.
I can't wait to see him his senior year.
I don't want to see him.
As a freshman, do you dare say that he's running scared?
No.
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 He doesn't look like it. He looks like he knows what he's doing.
Running with a purpose, I'll give you that.
Yeah.
First and 10 for North Miami. Lynn goes in motion left. He gets a pitch going left. Lynn looking for the sideline, now cuts it upfield. And he is cut down right at the sticks. I'm not sure if that was any gain there at all. Maybe one. Near side mark is at the 46. Give him one. It'll be second and 9. 3-30 to play. In the first half, we're tied at 14. North Miami has 2 timeouts left. I believe Rochester has 2 as well.
Sounds about right.
Clock rolls. Ball in the far hash, which is the Rochester sideline. Mikesell will go split to the left. The white out to the near side is Ribble. Under center is Jacob White with 12 on the play clock. Sets a line with 10. White on 2nd and 9 on the option. Keeps it going left. And White falls across the 45 to around the 44. Give him 2. It'll be 3rd and 7 with 2:50 to play in the first half. Again, we're tied at 14 here at North Miami.
So I want to talk about a balanced attack from North Miami. They've got 4 people that have carried the ball tonight, all of them 5 times, ranging from 10 yards to 43 yards.
Yeah,
pretty balanced.
3rd and 7 for the Warriors. Interesting play call here.
Oh, yeah, White's thrown the ball for 5 times as well.
And he could do it again here on the Rochester 44. Down to 10 on the play clock. Jacob White draws the Zebras off sides.
Now you got short, 3rd and short.
That'll be 3rd and 2 after a 5-yard walk-off. Tanner Music.
I'm trying to find out. It was Adam Basham.
Okay.
I think.
So now it's going to be 3rd and 2, which is a whole different kind of play calling.
Yeah, you're right.
Inside the Rochester 40. 2:20 to play in the first half. We're tied at 14 here in North Miami.
Again, go with the long count.
Yeah, why not? If they're going to give you 3-5 yards, then do it again. White sets a club. In motion is Sumner. Gets the pitch coming to the near side. Sumner outruns the defense and caught from behind by Beck and is ripped down.
I think he's making it.
I think from that spot he might have gotten a yard. It'll be 4th and short. And I think that Coach LaFever is asking for the horse collar, but he never got him from inside the pads. He just grabbed his jersey from behind.
Yeah, I agree with you.
So give him one. It'll be 4th and 1 at the Rochester 38-yard line with 1:45 to play in the first half. And are we going to be close enough for a measurement? I think we are. We're going to stretch the chains and see if this one, or how close this one is. Now, I don't think we're even going to measure. It's going to be a yard.
They look like they're a good half to a full yard short on the other side.
Well, I don't think I'd give it anybody else but number 30. Right up the middle.
He's doing
a great job as Will Miller up the middle. Or, one of the leading rushers in the conference, and Jacob White, the quarterback. I'd say.
I would agree with that.
So it'll be 4th and 1 for North Miami, 1:30 to play in the first half.
Zebras got nobody over center. Look for White to just keep it.
White takes a snap, he'll keep it going left. White churning his legs, backing his way. He gets close to the 40, close to the 37, I should say. And by the spot, that's gonna be enough for a Warrior first down. Yeah. It is without even a measurement.
Zebras.
Give him 2, it'll be 1st and 10 for the Warriors at the Zebra 36.
No nose guard for the Zebras on that lineup at defense. They had guys out over the guards. Leaves a 3-yard gap right in front of the center.
1st and 10 for the Warriors at the Rochester 36. But however, we're down to 1:15 to play in the first half. We're tied at 14. What do we do here? I would say White's got to air it out here shortly, I'd say. Back to passes, White looking right, throwing right. It is complete to Ribble, who grabbed that in double coverage as he gets to the Rochester 31. And now North Miami will take a timeout. It is not a first down. He gets 5 yards, but when we come back, it'll be 2nd and 5 for the Warriors with 61 seconds to play. Tied at 14, you're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 61 seconds to play in the first half. The Warriors, after a 5-yard pass play, uses their 2nd of 3 timeouts. They'll have it at the Rochester 31, going to our right. Now White will be out of the shotgun. 2 receivers left, 1 right. White takes a snap. Rolls to the left, getting a little pressure, throws it up for grabs. It is incomplete on that far side, and that'll bring up 3rd down and 5 as Schaefer and also Hadashell bearing down on him.
Yeah, I don't know how he could see to throw that ball. You also, Adam Basham was also back there as well. He had 3 Zebras chasing him. It looked like he just lobbed one up there and hoped for the best.
He's lucky that wasn't picked off,
absolutely.
Really.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I would say the biggest play of this first half I don't know. There's been a lot of big plays.
The block punt.
Well, how about that penalty on 3rd and 7?
Yeah. Yeah.
So 3rd down and 5 for the Warriors at the Rochester 31-yard line. 55.6 to play in the first half. We're tied at 14. The Warriors with the football on the near hash. We'll send Stiver wide to the left side. Ribble wide to the near side. Now back under center is White. Jacob White sets a line. Sumner comes in motion to the near side. On the option, White keeps it. Nobody fooled there as he carries the Zebras inside the 30 down to around the 29. Clock rolls with 48 seconds to play in the first half. It'll bring up fourth down and 3, and North Miami will use their last time out of the half. We'll take a 30. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 44.6 seconds to play in the first half. North Miami now out of timeouts. We're tied at 14, and North Miami will have it 4th and about 3 at the Rochester 29-yard line. They will go for it, although Stiver would be kicking with the wind. Ribble wide to the near side, 2 wideouts to the left, under center now is White. Jacob White, back to pass, looks left, looks right, pumps, throws right, down the sideline is Ribble. Ribble fights for the football, I believe, and Rochester defends it as Abbott and Hadashell ran into each other hard. Hadashell still down.
I don't think
they
didn't even see each other, ran right into each other, but they both thought they were going to get an interception right there at the goal line. They were probably.
So Rochester takes over on downs. It'll be 1st and 10. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Zebras at their own 29. They'll run one play probably, and if it doesn't go for anything, they'll just take a knee and down it, knowing they're going to get the ball first to start the second half.
You're right. Yep, I would agree. You don't want to risk a turnover here in the last few seconds of the half.
So that last play was at the Rochester 29, and now Rochester will start this play at their own 28. So hunting under center, Hadashell dots the eye. 2 wideouts to the right side is Bennett and Heckathorn. Here's a pitch to Hadashell going right. Hadashell spins away from a tackler in the backfield. Now cuts it upfield. Carries it across his 35 down to around the 36. And Rochester will use a timeout with 30 seconds to play. In the first half, we're tied at 14. Rochester will use a timeout. We're tied at 14. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 30.4 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester has it 2nd down and 3 at their 36-yard line going to our left. We're tied at 14. Bennett will break the huddle, come wide to the near side. Heckathorn, I believe, is split right. Hadashell and Beck will be in the I-back formation, and Hunting will be under center. Interesting. Hunting under center on 2nd and 3, back to pass. 3-step drop, throws down the right side, looking for Heckathorn. It is thrown out of bounds, and that'll bring up 3rd down and 3 with 25.9 to play in the first half.
That's about the third time tonight we've seen that pass. I think they like the matchup they're getting with Heckathorn. They just haven't been able to connect with the pass.
Well, the wind is, that ball is thrown so high, the wind is pushing it out of bounds 4 or 5 yards.
Yeah, yeah, all three of those passes, they've never had an opportunity to even make a play at the ball because it's been out of bounds.
So it'll be 3rd down and 3, more than likely a running situation here for the Zebras. You would not want to stop the clock in 4th and 3 and hope for a bad snap and a punt. Back to pass, what do I know? Hunting throws down the near side to Bennett. Bennett grabs the football, comes down with it at the North Miami 35-yard line. Is that going to be picked off?
Yes.
It will be. Jacob White rips the ball away from Bennett and picks off the football.
Bennett tried to argue that he had possession, but I don't think he ever did.
I'm not sure.
White had the ball first, and he came up with it afterwards.
I think that Bennett and White came down on the ground, both of them with hands on the football. Now they're discussing it, both of them with hands on the football. And while on the ground, White rips it away, and they're going to call it an interception.
I think Bennett gave up too early.
I think White had it first.
Yeah,
and Bennett tried to put his hands on it as they fell to the ground to try and give them the illusion that he caught it, and I don't think he ever did.
Coach Zahner out at the hash mark complaining that it was a tie, and I think—
No, I don't think it was.
I don't think it ever was.
Well, he's complaining it's a tie, which usually goes to the offensive player. So North Miami has it at their own 35. 19 seconds to play in the first half, and they'll just take a knee and go into the half in the locker room tied at 14. We're at halftime. The Zebras and the Warriors tied at 14. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI.
No less than a share of the conference title, regardless of the outcome tonight. One of their goals this year was to win the conference outright, and they've got 2 quarters to try and reach that goal.
Well, they're going to try something different in the second half.
I think so.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but. we'll all see together.
Wind's still pretty stiff out of the west-southwest.
Yeah. Well, I would say the first thing to do is try and find some heart.
Good call.
Yeah.
We had a D'Angelo's Pizza at halftime.
We sure did.
Yeah,
we
that
did.
Was excellent.
Yep.
There's still one more there, Mus.
Yeah, well, I got things to do.
I guess it's
really hard to do it with your mouth full.
You know,
I mean, if there was a way, I would do it for sure. So the North Miami Warriors will kick to the Rochester Zebras. The Zebras will go right to the left to start the second half. Back deep is Heckathorn. And just in front of him, about 4 or 5 yards, stands Abbott and Hadashell. Brad Thomas, Travis Watchering. I'm David Musselman. And we are ready for the second half as we're tied at 14 here at North Miami. Again, next week on the road to Twin Lakes, Monticello, Indiana. Actually, we'll be there. Well, we'll be there for a football sectional. Mm-hmm. And then 3 weeks after that, the varsity girls basketball season will start from there.
Start there, all right.
Nice little pooch kick. Hadashell takes it at the 30. Hadashell looking for some room to run around the 35, down to around the 38-yard line. So that's where Rochester will start this drive first off here in the second half.
I think that's North Miami saying, Jay Heckathorn, you are done getting the ball on kick returns.
Yeah, I'm not sure why anybody would kick to him. So Hunting, who was picked off late in that first half, will come back to the huddle. First and 10 for the Zebras at their own 38. Ball in the near hash, North Miami sideline. Bennett, Heckathorn wide to the right side. Beck, Hadashell in the I formation. From the 38, first and 10. Hunting takes the snap. Hands off to Hadashell right up the middle. Jacob Hadashell cut down at the 40. Pickup of about 2. North Miami doing a great job as they have all night. They're controlling the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, once again, Rochester finding it tough to run between the tackles. They've had a little bit of success if they can get around on the corners, but running-wise, there hasn't really, outside of about 2 plays by Hadashell, there hasn't been a whole lot anywhere.
One of those, a 28-yard touchdown run.
You're right.
Second and 8 for the Zebras. 2 flankers this time for Hunting. Heckathorn in motion to the right side on the jet sweep, hands it off, then hands it back to Hadashell. Hadashell down the near sideline. Hadashell at the 50, the 45, the 40, at the 35, center steps at the 30, stiff arm at the 25, and actually he's cut down to the 26-yard line, a first and 10 now for Rochester at the North Miami 26. The jet sweep started right. Heckathorn took about 3 steps, handed off to Hadashell, who brought it around the near side and down to the 26.
34-yard pickup by Hadashell.
I don't think Coach LeFevre is real happy about that stiff arm out of shell.
Kind of got a hold of the face mask with the stiff arm.
First and 10, what was that, 34 yards? 137 yards for out of shell?
Yeah.
Jeez, that's as quiet as 134 I've heard of all year.
You're right.
Out of shell in motion to the near side. On the end around is Heckathorn. Heckathorn wide open, going to the end zone. Touchdown Zebras, untouched from 26 yards. The Zebras strike first.
Well, Jay Heckathorn doing a great job. He just turned on the jets. I don't think the North Miami defense, they were all looking for Hadashell. Heckathorn went the other way, untouched.
Jay Heckathorn, a 26-yard touchdown run with 10:51 to play in the third quarter, put the Zebras on top, 20-14 with a Wilson Lee kick coming.
And that didn't take long at all.
Yeah, you're right. We talk about big runs. Rochester put together 2 big runs there.
Yeah.
Snap is back, hold is down, kick is away, and it is good. 21-14 Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 10:51 to play in the third quarter. Rochester back on top.
3 plays, 62 yards, capped off by a Jay Heckathorn 26-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebras retake the lead 21-14 with 10:51 remaining in the third quarter.
Wilson Lee to kick with the wind a little bit. Jacob White back deep for North Miami. Also holding back there, and I believe Lynn back deep to receive the kick. And just like North Miami did, I would do the same thing if I was Rochester. I'd keep it away from 32.
Yep, kick it to an up man.
So Wilson ready. Wilson Lee gets the green light and puts a right foot into it. High end over end kick. Going to come right back down to actually Lynn, then muffs it. Lynn picks it up. Being chased to the near side. Hunting then drops him at the 24. Right through the hands Fortunately, it did not do anything, but basically checked up right in front of Lynn, who picked it up and returned it out to the 24. So that's where North Miami will start this drive, with Rochester up 21-14 with 10:45 to play in the third quarter.
Now, the defense been on their heels a little bit here in the first half. We'll see how they respond in the second.
Meixel goes wide to the left side, which is the wide side of the field. Ribble wide to the near side. White will be under center. Wilson behind him. Miller, that is. On the snap, on the option. The pitch comes out here to Sumner, and Sumner is driven out of bounds. Wilson Lee got a shot in on White, and right before Wilson Lee hit him, White pitched it out to Sumner.
Bennett
carries it up to the 29.
Bennett on the tackle. He did a good job of fighting off the block in order to get out there to get that pitch man, Sumner.
Give him 6 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down and four for the Warriors at their own 30-yard line. Ribble wide to the near side. Michael split left. White relays the play to the line of scrimmage and now sets the club. On second and four, White gives to Miller over the left side. Miller stacked up and pushed backwards. Picked up about 3 yards. It'll bring up third down and one with 10.5 to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 21-14 here in week number 9 of the high school football season. Third and one for the Warriors at their own 33. White brings a play in from the sideline. Ball in the middle of the field for North Miami. Ten on the play clock. White ready on third and one. Jacob White takes a hand or takes a snap, dives ahead to the 35. Give him two. It'll be a first down for the Warriors as the sticks move. First and 10 for the Warriors at their own 35-yard line. Just under 10 minutes to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 21-14. Mike's will split to the near side, short side of the field. Ribble wide left. Sumner goes in motion left, gets a pitch going left, has some blockers in front, cuts it upfield. Sumner backs his way to his 45-yard line, maybe to the 46, and give him the 46, and that'll be enough for another Warrior first down after an 11-yard play, or carry, that is, by Sumner.
That play's worked well for North Miami all night long. The quick pitch out to Sumner.
Yeah.
They've been hitting him full speed, full stride, and he's able to get around that corner and pick up good yardage.
He's had blockers in front of him, that's for sure. First and 10 for the Warriors at their own 46. White ready. Again, Rochester leading 21-14. Sumner motion to the left side, fakes the pitch, runs to the near side, being pressured by Schaefer, flips it out, and behind Miller, incomplete. Actually, that was Wes Beck on the chase, wasn't it? Wes Beck was pressuring White as he did not bite on the fake pitch, but instead, when White rolled to his right, Wes Beck was right there giving chase.
Chasing him down, yep. Hadashell on the coverage short, and Hunting on the coverage deep.
Fortunate was Jacob White. That wasn't picked off and thrown it that far behind your intended receiver.
You're right. I don't think anybody was going to catch Hadashell if he catches that football.
Yeah. Second down and 10 for North Miami, their own 46. White has a play with 10 on the play clock. Sumner goes in motion on the option. Miller right up the right, off the right side. Maybe a couple. It'll be third and about eight.
Nice job by McLaughlin and Harper.
Harper?
51. Who is that this week?
Music. Tanner Music. Music.
Okay.
Second down. Make that third down and eight for the Warriors. 9 minutes to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 21-14. Ball in the middle of the field. Michael wide to the near side. Ribble split left. More than likely a passing down for Jacob White. From his own 48, Sumner in motion. Gets the pitch going left. Sumner, and it is cut down after about a 1 yard gain. That'll bring it up third down and about, make that fourth and seven at the North Miami 49-yard line.
Zebras did a much better job that time. Wilson Lee out there, as well as McLaughlin for the Zebras, did a much better job reading that pitch. Good. Sweep to Sumner.
The punter, Jacob White.
Yeah. Yep, Mr. Everything.
He stands at 35, lines up to punt. We'll see. Heckathorn slides back to his 20. Man, this scares me.
He's back there all by himself. Everybody else is up along the line of scrimmage.
Sumner's got to come back into the game. 10 on the play clock, plenty of time for that young man to get set. Fourth down and 7 for North Miami. Ball goes to White. White kicks it away, end over end kick. And they kick it away from Heckathorn. It goes out of bounds. And the referee is going to mark it out of bounds at the 20. So a pretty good kick by Jacob White. And the Zebras will take over for the second time this half, leading 21-14. They'll start at their own 20-yard line going to our left.
So the Zebras defense gets the stop.
That's exactly what they needed after coming after that halftime.
Yep. Yeah, you're right.
Coach Zander probably got on them a little bit. They came out. Three quick plays and scored. Held North Miami to no score at all.
Well,
so
I'm guessing since they're on fall break, if they didn't want to go to two-a-days next week, they probably needed to play a little better this second half.
First and 10 for the Zebras at their own 20. Bennett Heckathorn wide to the near side. Tight left is Shane. Hadashell dots the eye. Hunting under center on first and 10. John takes a snap, gives it to Beck right up the middle. Beck shakes the tackler to the line of scrimmage and maybe falls ahead for one or two, but that was going to turn into nothing. And he avoided one tackle and picked up a yard or two. It'll be second down and about 8 after, well, give him 3. It'll be second and 7 wow. after a 3-yard gain.
You know, sometimes I think that Wes Beck just feels like, once you stop me, I'm just going to stand here and see how many of you can pile on before I fall down.
Or before I just keep going.
Yeah.
That's all I get, one. Come on, fellas, you got more than that. Second down and 7. High back formation again for Rochester. Hadashell gets the carry going right. Kite tries to kick it back outside. Now tries to carry it back inside. Nothing there. It'll be third down and long. Boy, North Miami doing a fantastic job. They did the entire first half. They have owned the line of scrimmage in this half.
You're right.
7 minutes to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 21-14.
And they're really pursuing to the football, too. You're not just seeing one guy make the tackle. You're seeing 7 or 8 guys making a tackle.
Only one pass route, one pass play has worked tonight for Rochester, and that's the comeback route by Heckathorn. Mm-hmm. And this time Hunting will be out of the shotgun. Two backs there, back there beside him. Back to pass, looks to the near side, looking for Bennett. Bennett comes back to the football, throwing behind him a little bit. White on the coverage, incomplete. It'll be 4th and 7.
Zebras will need to punt away in order to keep field position.
Into the wind.
Yeah, great job by North Miami. And you know what happened the last time the Zebras punted?
Yeah. I don't think that'll happen again.
Well, it'll only be a 2-point safety this time. If they block it like they did last time, it'll be in the concession stand.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're going to knock that thing into Denver. And Coach LaFever just told the returner back deep to just fair catch it. So Wes Beck will kick it away. He stands on his 10. The ball goes to him. Good snap, no pressure. Low end over end kick. That's going to take a Rochester bounce. And it's going to come to rest in North Miami's 47-yard line.
I'm still not sure North Miami didn't get their hands on that one.
I think he just missed that one. So North Miami, after the punt, will take over in pretty good field position at their own 47. 6:29 to play, third quarter, Rochester up 21-14. I give him 46, maybe? Mm-hmm. I don't know. Boy. Opportunities, opportunities, opportunities. First and 10 for the Warriors at their 47. Michael split left. Rowe will be tight end to the right side. Jacob White has a play, relays it to the line of scrimmage. Now they come set on first and 10. Lynn goes in motion to the near side, far side. Miller has the football, carries it into Rochester territory, down to the 48. Give him about 4 or 5 on the play.
Brought down by Connor McLaughlin.
So it'll be second down and 5 after a 5-yard run for Miller, who's done that basically all night.
Yeah, he has. He's had a good night running so far for the Warriors.
Mark Deardorff from that far side running the down marker. I know he's listening. Second 5 on the option. Miller again right up the middle.
Another
and he's got
yards.
Another Warrior first down. Another 6 yards for the North Miami Warriors. It should be a first down.
Yep.
Nope, third. Oh,
they're
going to
measure. Wow, I thought that was a.
I did too. I thought that was an easy first down.
I did too.
It looks like it. But they're telling the Chang Gang to come on out.
5:53 to play in the third quarter, 21-14 Rochester.
That's first down by two footballs.
So he did get 6 yards.
Yeah.
I don't know why they just didn't ask. We tell them.
No kidding.
So first and 10 for the Warriors at the North Miami, I'm sorry, at the Rochester 43. Mikesell wide to the left side, which is the wide side of the field, ball in the near hash. Ribble tight right. Jacob White under center from the Rochester 43. Lynn goes in motion left, gets the pitch going left. Lynn with a bunch of blockers in front of him, cuts it back inside, carries it inside the Rochester 40 to the 39. Giving four, it'll be second and six.
Tackled by McLaughlin again. Also Brett Abbott on the stop.
Second and six after a 4 yard run. White on the option, gives to Miller right up the middle, and nothing there. Rochester finally makes a stand right up the middle on Miller, and that'll bring up third down and about five or six. Third down and five for the Warriors at the Rochester 39-yard line. Again, the Zebras leading 21-14.
And we've seen North Miami go on the long count on these third downs.
And it's worked. And this is about the point of the field. They did that last time. The spot of the field, you're right. Here's the pitch going to Sumner. Sumner kicks it outside. He carries the ball inside the Rochester 35 to the 34. And that's going to be close to a first down, but the spot, I believe, is going to be just a fuzz short. It'll be fourth and inches, I believe, for North Miami. We'll wait and see.
Measure it again.
The ball is on the 34-yard line of Rochester. And I believe they're going to have to get to about the 33 and three-quarter inch yard line. I don't know.
We'll see.
That sounded good, huh?
We'll just say you're right.
What? Say it again.
We'll say Brad's right. What?
So they stretch the chains. It will be
short.
Fourth and a foot. Fourth and a foot at the Rochester 34. 32 up the middle.
Or Miller.
Why would you even risk? You got the best quarterback,
one of the best athletes
in the league.
Well, I haven't seen Rochester put a nose guard over the center all night. So, yeah.
Fourth and foot for North Miami. They have to get to the Rochester, 33 and a half. Well, no, they have to get to the 34. It's about the 34 and a half right now. We keep horsing with the chains. I'll have a first down here in a minute.
What's going on?
Did he forget which side of the white chalk to put it on? Is that the problem?
Oh, gracious. How convenient. There's a power outage right now at West Central as Pioneer is pounding them 42-7. Somebody pulled the plug on that one,
didn't they? Yeah.
So fourth and inches for the Warriors at the Rochester 34. Now there's a nose guard. White takes a snap up the middle, leads ahead, and first down. That's what happens when you're 6'3". Just fall forward, and you got enough for a first down. In fact, giving two, it'll be first and 10 for the Warriors at the Rochester 32-yard line.
Yeah, when Coach Zander said he's the best running quarterback in the conference, he wasn't kidding. He's proved it here tonight.
Yep. You would think that those things would run out of air here pretty soon, wouldn't you?
I think they brought extra.
We saw three in one bag earlier.
How come all their shirts say Muscleman? That's what I don't know.
Yeah, all right. First and 10 for North Miami. White gives to Lynn on the counter, and he's dropped down at the line of scrimmage. Nice job by the Rochester Zebras to cut down that play at the line of scrimmage.
Lane Coffin in the backfield for the Zebras.
Loses a yard. It'll be second and 11. Austin, that's your aunt, by the way. second and 11 for North Miami. Inside the Rochester 35. Lynn comes in motion to the near side. Here's a handoff to Miller. Miller stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Not a lot there. It'll be third and long.
Back on the stop for the Zebras. Hadeshell coming in to help.
3:20 to play in the third quarter. Rochester leading 21-14. Give Miller a yard. It'll be third and 10 for the Warriors at the Zebra 32-yard line. Now Stiver comes in motion with the play. Meixel comes out. Ball in the near hash. North Miami going to our right. So the wide side of the field is Stivers. He goes wide to the left side. Also, Sumner goes wide to the left side. Out of the shotgun is Miller on third and 10. Out of the shotgun is White. White looks, throws right. It is over the head of Ribble. On the coverage is Bennett. And I think that White kind of double pumped that a little bit and then lost the handle as that thing kind of floated over the head of Ribble to be fourth down.
I think the right side of the line for the Warriors got lucky there. It looked like they chop blocked Westbeck pretty hard. He came up slow, and you could tell with his hands in his air, he wasn't happy.
Fourth and 10 for the Warriors at the Rochester 32-yard line. 2:42 to play in the third quarter. Again, the Zebras leading 21-14, and North Miami will go for it. White brings the play in from the sideline. The Warriors break the huddle with 13. Stiver, Lynn go wide to the left side. Ribble wide to the near side. Jacob White out of the shotgun with Miller to his right. Out of the shotgun on the option. Miller keeps it, and he is hit hard and dropped.
McLaughlin was not fooled by the fake to Miller, and he was right there to bring White
down. Coughing
down
as well. It's a gain of nothing. It'll be first and 10 for the Zebras at their own 33-yard line. Actually, he's going to lose a yard. Will White, and it'll be first and 10 for Rochester at the 33. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Final game of the regular season. And the Zebras leading 21-14 with 2.5 to play in the third quarter. Hadeshell dots the eye, hunting under center. John takes a snap. Flips it to Hadeshell, going right with blockers. Hadeshell cuts it up the field. Hadeshell down the far sideline. He's got the sideline. He's at the 35, the 30, the 20, the 15, the 10. Touchdown, Zebras. No flags.
Nice job by Jacob Hadeshell. He's able to get to the outside on the far sideline for the Zebras. Down that sideline, and he is gone. Nobody able to catch up with him. Heckathorn running interference between him and the closest Warriors.
Yeah, I think the only player who could have caught him there was Heckathorn, and he finally just stopped.
67-yard touchdown run by Jacob Hadeshell put the Zebras up 27-14.
That puts, once again, Hadeshell over 200 yards for the second week in a row.
So Wilson lead a kick. Have it to Holder. Snap is down, kick is away, and it is good. 28-14, Rochester, you're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 2:25 to play in the third quarter. Rochester now up 28-14, Trav. Hang on a minute. We'll do that after the scoring drive, after the kickoff. Wilson Lee ready. Lee, nice, high, end over end kick. White grabs the football inside the 20, slips, regains his balance, takes it all up the field. Grabbed by Abbott and brought down at around the 30-yard line, Trav.
Yep. One play, 67 yards. It was the Jacob Hadeshell 67-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebras take the lead. Well, Zebras keep the lead, 28-14, you know, with 2:20 in the third.
The bad thing about the play going away from us and going to the Rochester sideline, which is away from us, you can't see who threw a key block. With him, he ran down the field with nobody around him. There had to be three or four over there.
He got a couple of blocks that allowed him to get around the corner.
Yeah.
But the Zebras have run five plays since halftime and scored twice.
No kidding. Sumner motion to the near side, gets a pitch coming his side, shakes one tackler, and then Wilson Lee brings him down for a gain of nothing. Boy, Beck was in the backfield quickly, and nice job by Sumner cutting it inside Beck, but Wilson Lee there to clean it up for a gain of nothing. It'll be second and 10.
Our sectional opponent Friday, Twin Lakes, they are down to Judson 26-14 at halftime, and like you said, to another game, their power went out as well.
Huh.
So I don't know what it's from, but.
Well, you wouldn't think Judson would pull the power being up and at home.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Second and 10 for North Miami. Two wideouts to the left. Nobody to the right. Sumner motion to the left side. Miller gets the handoff right up the middle. Miller is met by a host of Zebras and brought down after a couple of yards gain. Coughing was there. Also, Music, Schaefer, and McLaughlin there for the Rochester Zebras. Give him three. It'll be third down and seven. With 90 seconds to play in the third quarter, Rochester up 28-14. Foot on the gas.
Yeah. Defense doing a little better job this second half, but North Miami still able to put together, string together some drives. They just haven't got it in the end zone yet.
Sumner in motion. Back to passes White. Here comes the pressure. Throws down the near side. It is tipped up and in. Then caught by Ribble. The Zebras had a shell, tipped it first, then Abbott tipped it, and then Ribble grabbed it on the third deflection and carried it to the Rochester 48 for a first down and 10.
Everybody just hanging around waiting to see where the ball is going to go.
In baseball, if you're keeping a book in baseball and the pitcher touches it and the second baseman touches it and then is thrown out at first base, you would call that a 1-4-3 put out. But how do you count that reception?
This is your linebacker, safety, receiver catch.
Well, and then the Zebras on top of that are going to get called for roughing the passer. So they're going to tack on another 15 yards.
From the 48.
Yeah, so we're looking at a 20-yard pass play with a 15-yard penalty on top of it.
So that will take the ball inside the Rochester 35-yard line to the 33. And North Miami in business. With a minute two to play in the third, Rochester up 28-14. Ball in the near hash. So the wide side of the field is the Rochester side. The Warriors going to our right. Mikes will go split to the right side. Ribble split left. Under center is White. Jacob sets the line on first and 10, gives to Sumner going left. Sumner met by his own man. Lynn was his leading blocker. Sumner ran right into the back of Lynn, and then Coffin cleaned up the mess. As he maybe got one, is not a lot. It'll be second down and long for North Miami. 35 seconds to play, third quarter.
Winamac leads Frontier 67-0.
There's nothing there. There was nothing there. Second and 10 after a gain of nothing for North Miami. Down to 25 seconds to play in the third, 28-14 Zebras. And we'll give you the Twin Lakes Jetson score here momentarily. Jacob White relays the play, sets the line of scrimmage on second and 10. Sumner in motion to the left. On the option, he keeps it, throws it out. It is loose. It should be an incomplete pass. It will be. It'll be third down and 10 with 10.6 to play in the third quarter. Great job by the Zebras on that far sideline. I didn't get a number, but they broke up that option play quickly.
Did a good job getting back into Jacob White, forcing him to get rid of it quicker than he wanted to. Lynn not able to turn around and get his hands on the football.
I think that was McLaughlin who disrupted the pitch.
I think you're right, too.
Schaefer was there to hit Sumner if he got the ball. Third and 10 for North Miami at the Rochester 33-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Mikesell wide right, Ribble split left on third and 10. White under center, pitches to Sumner going left. Sumner cuts it back inside. And it's tackled about the 30, giving three. It'll be fourth and a seven. When the fourth quarter begins, after three, Rochester leads 28-14. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Fourth and final quarter we go. Rochester's one quarter away from running the table in the TRC. However, like we just said, well, like I just said, foot on the gas, and now it's raining. Awesome.
Raining, yeah.
Fantastic. Raining now at North Miami. The Warriors with the football, fourth and seven as we start the fourth and final quarter. It's at the Rochester 30. The Zebras leading 28-14, and I believe it just did start raining.
It did, yeah. Just a light kind of drizzle. Looks like it's blowing in rather than falling in.
So North Miami will go for it. White will be in the shotgun with Miller to his right. Four receivers in for North Miami in fourth and seven. Here's a snap, back to passes, Jacob White steps up, hit as he throws it. Down the near side to Stiver, incomplete. Rochester takes over on downs. Intended for Jacob Stiver. It'll be first and 10 for the Zebras at their own 30-yard line, going to our right, 11:55 to play in the game.
Zebras doing a good job getting pressure on Jacob White, making him throw that as soon as sooner than he intended to, and it lands incomplete.
So Rochester takes over on downs. Ball in the near hash going to our right. Again, the Zebras up 28-14. Bennett and Heckathorn will go split left. Shane will be tight to the left side. I-backs for John Hunting. John under center. Long count takes a snap. Pitches to Hadashell with Beck in front of him. Hadashell stiffs arm, looking for the outside. He's got a Warrior on his back. is ridden out of bounds at about the 35. So he picks up about 5 yards. Thank you.
Last I've heard, 20-8, Whitco over Valley. You got Judson.
Yeah, I had, well, there's 11 seconds left in the half when the power went out, and it was North Judson 26, 14, Twin Lakes, and they were deciding whether or not they're gonna finish, wait for the half, or wait till the lights come on and play the last 11 seconds.
11 seconds of the half?
Yeah, that's when the power went out.
Second and six, pitch to Hattishell. On the reverse, gives to Heckathorn.
Blockers
in front of him. Stiffs arm one tackler. Down the far sideline. Heckathorn off to the races. Heckathorn at the 30, the 25. Still on his feet. Shakes a tackler. Looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras.
70 yards for Jay Heckathorn. Is that right? 65 yards.
66 yards, yep. Jay Heckathorn, a 66-yard touchdown run on a reverse to put the Zebras up now 34-14. With 11:32 to play in the football game. And Wilson Lee will be on to attempt the extra point.
They'll put Heckathorn over 100 yards for the night on 5 carries.
You know, there was 2 or 3 games there in a row where he should have been over 100, but because of penalties,
yeah,
he got maybe 60.
Yep.
So Wilson Lee to kick, snap is back, hold us down, kick is away, and it is good. 35-14, Rochester, you're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 11 and a half to play in the game. Rochester scores, travel on another long drive, or long run.
Short drive, long run.
Yeah.
2 plays, 70 yards. Capped off by the Heckathorn reverse for 66-yard touchdown. The PAT was yet again good by Wilson Lee. He is 5 for 5 tonight. Zebras have the lead 35-14 with 11 and a half remaining in the fourth quarter.
One time tonight, the Rochester Zebras have scored in 5 yards or less.
Just one time, yeah.
Just one time.
Yeah, they've had touchdown runs of 28, 67, 26, and 66.
Other than the 12 plays to start the game on the touchdown, their touchdown drives have been 4 plays, 3 plays, 2 plays, 1 play.
35-14, Rochester, and Wilson Lee to kick. Back deep is Jacob White. Nice end over end, long kick. White goes, watch it, goes over his head in the back of the end zone, a touchback.
I think that's
Wilson
the first
Lee
one.
With a touchback.
First one I've seen
right
all year.
On.
Yeah.
Good for him. Rex Reinholdt, you're a genius. So the Warriors will take over at their own 20 after the touchback with the Rochester Zebras leading 35-14. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Ball in the middle of the field. Wilson Lee had to quickly change his shoe, now joins the defense. So White will be under center. Miller behind him. From his 20, Sumner comes in motion to the near side. On the option, Miller right up the middle. Not a lot there. Not a lot there. You know, this is, it's almost kind of a typical Rochester game. The opponent fellows win the battle. Win the battle up front. Win the battle up front. Win the battle up front. And then when you think that Rochester can't win the battle, now they're just starting to blow everything up on the line of scrimmage.
Starting to wear them down as the game goes on. And
we have seen that many times this year.
Game after game. Better second half team.
Second and 10 for North Miami. Sumner make that Lennon motion. On the option, Miller right up the middle, and he's hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. Nothing there, it'll be third and 10.
Schaefer just gobbled him up.
Third and 10 for the North Miami Warriors. With 10:45 to play in the football game, Rochester up 35-14. In a last report, North Judson leading Twin Lakes late in the first half. They were also experiencing a power outage, as is West Central, but West Central's was ugly when that power went out. It was 42-0 Pioneer. Third and 10 for North Miami. White again under center. Sumner in motion to the right. Fakes the pitch, rolls to the near side. Here comes the pressure. Connor Lee, or make that, McLaughlin couldn't catch him. White keeps it, gets it out to the 25, maybe to the 26. It'll be third, fourth down and 4, as Schaefer is there to bring him down. Also Heckathorn there to bring him down as well. Actually give him 7, it'll be 4th and 3. Under 10 to play in the game. North Miami will go for it. Well, You would think they would, but White is the punter as well. And he will be under center. Fourth down and three for the Warriors at their own 27-yard line. White with the under center for North Miami. Now stands up, looks to the sideline with six on the play clock, and looks like we'll burn a timeout with three, with two, and now North Miami will use a timeout. 9:25 to play in the game. Rochester up 35-14. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 9:25 to play in the game. Rochester up 35-14. North Miami has just used their first timeout of the second half, and they'll be looking at fourth down and three if Bradley decide to go for it here.
Yeah, and I believe they will.
But with that being said, the punter is also the quarterback.
You're right.
The quarterback is also the punter.
Yeah, and he's playing in under center.
Yeah, I was going to say, and he's not in the shotgun, so it won't be.
They've had some backs with him, Jacob White and Miller both, you know, getting 5 yards at a pop. So
fourth and three for the North Miami Warriors at their own 27. They will go for it. Sumner in motion to the near side on the option. He is stacked up as Miller and brought down after a 2-yard loss.
Yeah.
And it'll be first and 10 for the Zebras at their own 25.
McLaughlin right there in the backfield for the Zebras, grabbing a hold of Miller just as White tucks the ball away inside of him.
I'm not sure, Brad, if that was a true option play. White could have taken that ball out of the belly because McLaughlin hit him so quick.
Yeah, I don't know whether the ball just got caught up in there. You know, the way as quickly as McLaughlin was back there, he couldn't get it pulled out because McLaughlin had a hold of him.
Yeah. So Rochester takes over on downs at the 25-yard line of the North Miami Warriors. Two wideouts to the left side. Ball in the near hash. Ibacks for Hunting. John hands off to Hadashell up the middle. John slips, regains his footing, carrying the ball inside the 25 to around the 22. 3-yard gain for the senior. It'll be second down and 7, who has had a monster night.
Yeah, I've got him for 212 yards on 15 carries and 3 touchdowns.
But the question of the night is, what's Tanner Hughes doing?
Yeah, you're right. I'm willing to bet he's probably not going to get 200. I don't know, maybe.
I was thinking more like 300.
Okay. Well, the last I heard is 26-8 in favor of Whitco.
Second and 7 for the Zebras at their own at that North Miami 22-yard line. Beck gets a rare carry this game. Beck right up the middle. Wes Beck carries the North Miami Warriors inside the 5. Now actually to the 5. It'll be first and goal for the Zebras at the North Miami 5-yard line.
Wes Beck's longest carry of the night.
17 yards.
Yeah, get him 17.
For the senior. Yeah, how many carries he had? Not many.
He's had 7 carries.
Okay.
And that run there was as much as he'd had all night long.
First and goal for the Zebras at the North Miami 5. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. A Monticello we will go next week.
Now the Zebras too close to score.
Trav, you have the responsibility now
of
watching who grabs the Gatorade bucket.
And whoever wants to run the most Monday.
Beck looking for the end zone. Touchdown Zebras on a 5-yard run for Wes Beck. You suppose Coach Zahner said nobody gives me the bucket?
Yeah, but as a player, you don't listen to that.
Yeah.
Sorry, Zahner.
8:06 to play in the game. Rochester now up 41-14.
The Zebras now with 369 rushing yards.
Wilson lead it. Attempt the extra point. Snap is back. Hold is down. Kick is away. Man, that's a nice looking kick. It's good. 42-14, Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 8:06 to play in the game. Wes Beck gets in the scoring action.
3 plays, 25 yards. Like you said, Wes Beck, first touchdown of the night, 5-yard touchdown run. The PAT was good again by Wilson Lee. Zebras maintain the lead, 42-14 with 8 to go in the fourth quarter.
You know, you don't see very, very much anymore, high school, college, pro level, the head coach not wearing a headset. Mark LaFever's like that. He hasn't had a headset on all night.
No.
Wilson Lee, a shorter kick this time. Lynn takes it at the 21. Lynn up the middle at the 25 at the 30 and spun down at about the 33, 34-yard line. So that's where North Miami starts this possession. Again, the Zebras up 42-14. Don't forget that this thing was tied at 14 at halftime.
Yeah, I was about to say, whatever Coach Zahner said at the halftime, it worked.
They message received loud and clear.
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, the same, the number one defense stays out there still.
First and 10 for the Warriors at their own 33.
I still think he just wrote two-a-days on the chalkboard and then walked back
out. That would
out.
Do it, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Jacob White under center. Takes a snap, hands off to Sumner. Sumner carries it across the 35 to around the 36. Giving three, it'll be second and seven. North Miami make that second and six after a four-yard gain, giving the 37. North Miami, I believe, will host Southern Wells next week. And round one of the Class 1A sectional. Rochester will travel to Monticello to battle Twin Lakes in game number one. That's okay.
Yeah.
Need a bus ride when you're on fall break.
Yeah.
Here's a pitch to Holden. Holden takes the pitch, coming to the near side, just about had a stripped crush to the 42. A pickup of six. And he's going to be close to a Warrior first down.
Some score updates around the area. Southwood leads Wabash, or no, I'm sorry, Southwood and Wabash are tied 21-21. Whitco leads Valley 28-6. Northfield leads Manchester 21-7. Judson Twin Lakes still we have 26-14. Frontier 0, Winnemac 67 final. Pioneer 42, West Central 7. Tri-County 20, Caston 22. Hamilton Heights 40, Peru 0. And whoever Lewis Cass was playing, they were up 12-0 in the fourth quarter.
Whoever Lewis Cass is
playing. Val gives us these scores. He talks so fast. I'm right down. You should see. I didn't spell any of these right. I just throw letters out there.
You're taking shorthand in college?
I hope these scores and everything's right.
Nobody's listening anyway.
Exactly. That's what I'm thinking.
I'm guessing nobody under the age of 35 even knows what shorthand is.
Yeah, because that's why I ignored it, because I don't know what it is. I just kept going.
Oh, Brad. All right, fellas, I'm out. You're in. I'm out.
It's about
out.
Time. There's all the viewers. They're back. Les is out.
So it'll be third and inches for North Miami.
Where's the air horn when you need one?
Yeah.
Don't say that too loud.
Light that thing up. I'm going to start bringing my own can of air.
There you go. I'm not going to say anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
Third and one for the Warriors. At their own 42-yard line, 7:15 to play in the game. Rochester up 42-14. White takes the snap and didn't go well. Second effort might have got him to the sticks. He was bottled up in the backfield. Kept his legs moving, and second effort got him out to the 44. So that's enough for a Warrior first down. Give him two, and that moves the chains.
Miami first down.
Ball in the near hash. North Miami going to our left. And obviously right now Coach LeFevre wants to perfect things as he gets ready for Southern Wells.
Yeah, you're right. I was just noticing North Miami, 3 of 8 and a touchdown in the first half. They've only had one completion out of six.
Yeah, really?
In the second.
White on the option gives to Miller right up the middle. Miller is brought down on a solo tackle by
Connor
McLaughlin. Yep, it takes it out to the 46-yard line, a pickup of two. It'll be second and eight. 6.5 to play in the football game. Rochester up 42-14 here at North Miami High School senior night. And the football senior night will be celebrated after the game.
Oh, okay.
Something new here.
Yeah.
Michael comes wide to the near side, short side of the field. Ribbles wide out to the right. White under center on second and eight. From the 46 in North Miami, Holden takes a carry and is hit hard by Schaefer at the 45.
Schaefer just picked him up and planted him on his back.
I hope that young man gets as big as his dad. I'm guessing after he picks himself up off the ground, he's wishing that same thing. Good heavens, Schaefer hit him hard.
Yeah.
He loses a yard. It'll be third down and nine. With 5:47 to play in the game, Rochester up 42-14.
Some new faces out there for the defense. We'll get to after this
good.
Play.
White under center on third and nine. Holden comes in motion to the near side, gets a pitch coming to the near side. Lee gives chase, slips a tackle, does Holden, and is ripped out of bounds to the Rochester right midfield. Right at midfield to bring up fourth down for the Warriors. Fourth.
Take it down after a gain of six.
And about four. With 5.5 to play in the game. Again, Rochester up 42-14.
And the new faces you see out there is number 4, Thomas Rensberger, 31, Ross Pearson, and 71, Matt Miller.
Fourth and four for the Warriors at midfield. Mixel wide to the right side, wide side of the field. Under center is White, where he's been the majority of the night. Here's a couple times out of the shotgun. Under center again, on the option to bust a play, gives to Holden. Holden's got a first down. Holden at the 45 of Rochester and driven backwards. Give him six on the play and another Warrior first down. That was a busted play from the word go. And White just gave it to Holden, who was coming around the left end and picked up enough for another Warrior first down. Ball now at the Rochester 45-yard line.
Alex Borg runs onto the field for the Zebra defense now.
First and 10 for North Miami in Zebra territory. On the option, Miller right up the middle. Miller's hit by McLaughlin first, pushes his way out to the 41. A pickup of 4 yards. It'll bring up second down and six with 5 minutes to go in the game. 42-14 Rochester. Rochester looking to complete their first sweep of the conference since 2008. And they're 5 minutes away from doing that. On second and six, White hands off to Holden. Shane Holden around the left side, lunges ahead to the 36, giving five. It'll be third and one for the Warriors.
Daniel Butler joins the game now for the Zebra defense.
Well, I like the Wilson kid. I like the Lynn kid. I'm sorry, I like the Miller kid. I like the Lynn kid and I like the Holden kid.
Yeah.
All freshmen and sophomores.
Youngsters coming up looking pretty good.
Third and a long one for the Warriors. Miller the setback. White under center. On the option, Miller gets it right off the right side. Stood up at the 35-yard line. That's going to be close to a first down. And we're going to measure again, aren't we? That ball right at the 35. It'll either be first and 10 or fourth and inches. No signal yet. They're going to bring the chains across.
And as they do, another new face joins the defensive core, Austin Foster.
It would be nice to see the Zebras get the football back here, I guess, just so we could get some new faces in offensively.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 3:52 to play in the game. North Miami will have it fourth and inches at the 35-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. Again, Rochester leading 42-14 here in the final game of the regular season. And it'll be fourth and inches, as I think they've got to get the entire football on the across the 35. It was just inches. And North Miami's looked at has looked at several fourth down plays tonight where Jacob White just keeps the football and just falls ahead.
I'm assuming that's what we'll see right here.
I would agree with that as well.
Thanks.
First time this year, Trav.
First time ever.
Ever. Good. 3.5 to play in the game. White the snap, left side of the line, a first down. White still on his feet and carries the ball out to the 31. So giving four on a fourth down, it'll be first and 10 for the Warriors at the Rochester 31-yard line with 3.5 to play in the game with the Zebras up 42-14. And now North Miami will use a timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 3:29 to play in the game. It's first and 10 for the Warriors at the Rochester 31-yard line. And I believe the seniors are going to come out to hopefully a standing ovation. And we're going to have some new faces in the game for the North Miami Warriors, and we'll try to get those here momentarily. New quarterback in the game will be Alex Kuhn, a 5'5 sophomore for the North Miami Warriors. And what did White finish with tonight, Brad?
I've got him 54 yards rushing on 15 carries and 4 of 13 and a touchdown for 83 yards.
Alex Kuhn in the backfield gives to Holden going right. Shane Holden lowers his head, carries a group of tacklers inside the Rochester 35-yard, make that 30-yard line down to around the 27. So he picks up four, it'll be second and six.
A few new Zebra faces as well. Anthony Smith joins the game Hunter Nard joins the game. And I'm sure there's more out there that I'm not seeing.
Anthony Smith, I believe, is a freshman.
He's a sophomore.
Okay.
25, which is Liam Leininger, joins the game.
Had a fantastic JVC team season. Second and six for North Miami. Kuhn at the 27. Hands off, I believe. Riviera, is that right? 25?
Yeah.
I'm going to have to use your glasses here in a minute, Brad.
Should have brought your own.
I know, I forgot them. Give him a yard, it'll be third and five. 2:25 to play in the game. Rochester up 42-14.
And 44, Trent Bauer joins the game as well.
Kuhn under center. On the option, he keeps it around the near side. Alex Kuhn grabbed, stopped his firm momentum at the 16. Picks up about nine and another Warrior first down.
Gain of 10 on the play. The game is good for North Miami. First down.
Alex Kuhn will have the offense in his hands come next year. Just a sophomore. And sophomore, what, tailback?
Yeah, it was long. Right.
Fullback.
As well as Will Miller, the freshman. Trevor Lynn, the sophomore.
Yeah.
And Lane Eckert, the junior.
Got a good nucleus building for the next couple of years.
And don't forget Jeff Eckert, who is hurt, is a sophomore. Alex Kuhn, route running for his life. There's a mix-up, and he is going to go backwards.
He's going to pay the
price. To the 24. Yeah, he's going to lose about seven. Maybe the 23 loses about six. A minute 20 to play in the football game. You watching the Gatorade buckets?
My eyes are all over it.
Yeah, they were. yeah, they were.
I think it's going to be a coach that does it.
So, yeah, right.
I think it's going to be Brad.
Second 16, 60 seconds to play in the regular season. Kuhn, hands off. I believe.
Well, I don't know who that was.
Listen, though, Xander comes up here wet. He's sitting on your guys' side.
Using your headphones.
Ah, crap.
35 seconds to play in the game. Third and 15 for the Warriors at the Rochester 22. Zane Briggs is in the game.
That's what the parents say.
And Briggs, I believe, it was the quarterback on that series, and he and the fullback, a little bit of a mix-up, and that should do it for the game. Gain of nothing, and that'll do it. The Rochester Zebras complete a sweep of the conference by defeating North Miami tonight 42-14. For the first time since 2008, Rochester wins a conference outright. Post-game show coming up next, 92.1 WROI.